Good morning, students. Now the third chapter of physics studies gravitation. First, we should know what is a gravitational force, and you have already studied this chapter, so I think you should know that. This gravity is first discovered by the Newton, Isaac Newton, the scientist who first discovered that this is a gravity or the gravitational force. So, what happened with Newton? He was sitting near under the tree. An apple tree, and he saw that an apple drop on his face, and he think that by this apple on drop on the earth, why it do not drop, why do not moves in the upward direction. So by this incident, he find he show that there is some gravitational force which is exerted by the earth on every objects surrounding the earth, and this force is called the gravity. So what is the gravity? Gravity is a force with which the earth attract all objects towards its center. So this is our earth, and it attract every other object surround it towards its center, and this force is called the gravitational force. This is about the earth. The other planets also have the gravitational force. The other planets which are bigger than the earth, like the Jupiter, has its gravitational force is really larger than our earth. So actually the gravitational force depends on the mass of the earth, or we can say the other planets, and the distance between the objects. So this gravity, or we can say the gravitational force, was first discovered by the Isaac Newton. So he gave a law which is called the universal law of gravitation. Universal law of gravitation. What is this law? This law was given by the Newton, who first discovered the gravitational force, and according to which, suppose, just try to understand it, then I will tell you what is the law actually. Suppose these are two objects having the mass m1 and m2, and they are placing at a distance of d from each other, or it can be represented by d, it can be represented by r. So I am representing it by d. So this is the distance in between these two objects. So according to Newton, or according to this law, every object in this universe, either me or this pen, or the me and this book, or this table and this chair, all the objects which are present in the universe have some force in between them. This attraction force, which is directly proportional to the product of the mass of the objects. It means this force depend on the mass of the objects. If the objects have the higher mass, the force will be greater. So, for example, you can understand it easily by example. Suppose you are here, this is you, and this is a table or the chair. This is a table. And according to the law, we know that then you and this table have the force, some force in between you. There should be some force in between you and this table. So this force which is exerted between you and this table is directly proportional to the mass of both of you, that is of you and this table. Since you and this table has not enough mass, so the force is really so less. This force is it even so less that you are not able to feel it. Aapko mehsoos bhi nahi hoga ki aapke aur uske beech mein koi force exert ho raha hai. But in the case of the earth, suppose this is earth and this is an apple. So in case in this earth and an apple, we know that the mass of the apple is very less, but the mass of the earth is so huge, so large. So the force exerted is really so large. So this force is directly proportional to the product of the mass of the objects, and is inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them. It means if you increase the distance between them, the force going to be decreases. And if you decrease the distance between them, the force going to be increases. So if we combine these two things, this is a universal law of gravitation. So the law is every particle of matter in the universe. Okay, so this particle or this matter can be anything in this universe. So every particle in the matter of the matter in the universe attract every other particle with a force which varies directly to the product of the masses of the two particles and inversely at the square of the distance between them. Okay, so this is the law. And again, for writing any law, you also have to derive this law. Like this, you will write it like the mass of the two objects. Let the mass of the two objects are m1 and m2, and these objects are placed at a distance of d. Now we can say that distance between the centers of these objects are d. So according to the Newton universal law of gravitation, we can say that F directly proportional to m1 m2, this is equation first. Inversely proportional to 1 upon d squared, this is equation second. And we can combine both these equations, then it will be F directly proportional to m1 m2 upon d squared. This is equation second. That was the equation second. So by combining these law, these two parts, we find that F directly proportional to m1 m2 upon d squared. Now we have to remove this directly proportional sign and we have to add some constant. Like we are adding the constant like capital G here, and it's really important. Capital G is called the universal gravitational constant. This is called the universal gravitational constant. The value of G is constant in whole universe. It do not vary by changing the mass or the distance. So the value of G is constant everywhere. So this is called the universal gravitational constant. Okay. So this is called the universal gravitational constant. Now let's talk about the universal gravitational constant. So for finding the value of G, we can solve it like this. We can put this D square in multiplication with F. This is the cross multiplication method and m1 m2. Okay, so suppose you are placing two objects or having the mass of 1 kg. So these are two objects having the mass of 1 kg. Now we are placing these two objects at a distance of 1 meter. We always take the values in SI unit, like the kg is the SI unit for the mass and the distance at the SI unit of meter. So this is the distance between the two objects. So F should be equal to the G 1 into 1 upon 1 square. The mass of the two objects is 1 and 1 upon 1 square. So F will be equal to G. So after calculation, scientists find that this value of G, it means the value of F, when two objects having the mass of 1 kg are placed at a distance of 1 meter, this is 6.67 10 to the power minus 11. It's really so smaller quantity. This is a force exerted in between the two objects which is having the mass of 1 kg and which are placed at a distance of 1 meter from each other. So this value, this force is equal to the G, and this G is this one. What should be the unit of this G? The unit of force is Newton, distance having the meter square upon mass having the kg, so kg square. So this is SI unit of universal gravitational constant, that is Newton meter square per kg square. So this is all about the universal law of gravitation. So the SI unit of universal gravitational constant is Newton meter square per kg square. Okay. Now you know the importance of a universal law of gravitation. What are the importance here? Importance of universal law of gravitation. So first one, there are lots of applications here. First one, all the planets revolve around the sun due to gravitational force. You know, this is the sun. And all the 8 planets are revolving around the sun. So how they are able to revolve around it? You know, every object which want to revolve around another object, there should be a centripetal force for that to revolve around it. कोई भी अगर ऑब्जेक्ट को गोल घूमना है किसी ऑब्जेक्ट के चारों तरफ, तो उसके लिए उसको एक फोर्स की रिक्वायरमेंट होती है, विच इज़ कॉल्ड द सेंट्रिपिटल फोर्स. एंड दिस सेंट्रिपिटल फोर्स दिस प्लैनेट गेट फ्रॉम द ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स विच इज़ एक्टिंग बिटवीन द सन एंड दैट प्लैनेट. दिस सन एंड द प्लैनेट बोथ हैव द हायर मास, सो द फोर्स बिटवीन देम इज रियली सो लार्ज. एंड दिस फोर्स इज यूज्ड बाय द प्लैनेट्स टू रिवॉल्व अराउंड द सन. So we can say the centripetal force is provided by the gravitational force which is acting between the sun and the planets. So this is the first application. So that all the planets revolve around the sun due to the gravitational force between the sun and the planet. So it means, what can we say? That the gravitational force is responsible for the existence of solar system. Gravitational force is responsible for existence of solar system. Okay, now the second one, gravitational force of the earth responsible for binding the object on the earth. Suppose we are here on this planet, the earth, and we are here. How you are able to stand on this planet? Because there is a force in between you and this earth which enables us to keep us on this earth. If agar yahan pe hamare beech mein koi bhi force nahi hoga to hum earth pe pair bhi nahi rakh payenge. Okay, so it means the gravitational force of the earth is responsible for binding gravitational force of earth is responsible for binding objects on the earth. Clear? So we are not going to stick with this earth, but we are able to move on this earth. और अगर आप वहाँ अर्थ से कहीं बाहर जाते हैं तो यू कांट स्टेप इवन लाइक एयर में, तो आप स्टेप नहीं रख पाते हो ना, क्योंकि देयर इज़ नो एनी अट्रैक्शन फोर्स इन बिटवीन देम. तो यूनिवर्स में आप कहीं बाहर निकल जाओ तो वहाँ पे कोई भी फोर्स एग्जर्ट, ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स नहीं होता, तो आप चल भी नहीं पाते. सो इट मीन्स अगर कोई भी ऑब्जेक्ट अर्थ पे टिका हुआ है तो इट इज़ ड्यू टू द ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स विच इज़ एक्टिंग बिटवीन द अर्थ एंड द ऑब्जेक्ट्स. थर्ड वन, रेनफॉल, स्नोफॉल, ऑल द रिस्पॉन्सिबल, ऑल इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल ओनली ड्यू टू द ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स ऑफ द अर्थ. अगर बारिश होती है तो अर्थ पे ही गिरती है, स्नोफॉल हो रहा है तो अर्थ पे ही गिर रहा है. वाई? बिकॉज अर्थ हैज सम ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स. सो वी कैन से दैट द रेनफॉल एंड स्नोफॉल इज पॉसिबल ओनली ड्यू टू ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स ऑफ अर्थ. ओके जी, नाउ नेक्स्ट पार्ट, फोर्थ पार्ट, मून एंड द ऑल आर्टिफिशियल सेलेस्टियल रिवॉल्व अराउंड द अर्थ. वी नो दैट दिस इज द सन एंड द अर्थ इज रिवॉल्विंग अराउंड द सन इन द थर्ड ऑर्बिट एंड मोस्ट ऑफ द सैटेलाइट्स आर रिवॉल्विंग अराउंड द अर्थ. सो हाउ दीज सैटेलाइट्स, इवन द मून और द आर्टिफिशियल सैटेलाइट्स आर एबल टू मूव अराउंड द अर्थ. This is all due to the gravitational force which is acting between the earth and the satellite. So we can say the moon and all artificial satellites revolve around the earth due to gravitational force which is acting between the earth and the satellite. Gravitational फोर्स एक्टिंग बिटवीन अर्थ एंड बिटवीन द अर्थ एंड द सैटेलाइट. ओके, नाउ द नेक्स्ट एप्लीकेशन. देर आर लॉट्स ऑफ एप्लीकेशन ऑफ ग्रेविटेशनल यूनिवर्सल ग्रेविटेशनल कॉन्स्टेंट सॉरी यूनिवर्सल ग्रेविटेशनल लॉ. नेक्स्ट वन इज द टाइड्स हाई. यू नो द हाई टाइड्स एंड द लो टाइड्स. आई थिंक यू हैव लर्न इट इन फिजिक्स सॉरी ज्योग्राफी नॉट द फिजिक्स दिस इज द फिजिक्स. सो इन ज्योग्राफी यू नो द हाई टाइड्स एंड द लो टाइड्स. होता है कभी पानी जो होता है वो सी वाटर वो बहुत ज़्यादा ऊपर चढ़ जाता है उसको बोलते हैं हाई टाइड्स. और जब वो सी शोर से नीचे उतर जाता है तो उसको बोलते हैं लो टाइड्स. सो दी टाइड्स आर ओनली ड्यू टू द ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स ऑफ मून एंड इवन ऑफ द सन. देखो क्या होता है, दिस इज द अर्थ. ओके, एंड देयर इज लॉट्स ऑफ वाटर अराउंड द अर्थ. वी नो दैट द 75% ऑफ अर्थ इज सराउंडेड बाय द वाटर. सो सपोज देयर इज अ मून, इट कैन बी अ मून, इट कैन बी अ सन. सो दिस मून अट्रैक्ट दिस वाटर टूवर्ड्स इटसेल्फ. Okay, because there is some gravitational force between the water and the moon. So due to this force, what happens actually, the water which is here is comes out to this side where it get attracted by the moon or it can be the sun. So this is the case of high tides. And what is about the low tides? Low tide means when there is no earth, when there is no moon or the sun, what happens actually, now there is no attraction force between the water and the moon or the sun. So what happens, this water flows out in opposite direction. So this is called the low tides. So these tides are due to the gravitational force acting between the sun, moon or the and the water. Next one is the atmosphere around the earth exists due to gravitational force of the earth. The atmosphere around the earth is due to the gravitational force. If there is no gravitational force, what bind this atmosphere towards the earth? तो सोचिए अगर यहाँ पर gravitational force ही नहीं होगा तो क्या चीज़ होगी जो atmosphere के particles को air particles को इसकी तरफ attract करके रखेगी. So the atmosphere of the earth is due to the gravitational force. Atmosphere of earth is due to the gravitational force of the earth. So these are some of the applications of universal law of gravitation. Now why this question can be raised in your mind, that why we don't able to feel the force which is acting in between you and the other objects. Though we have some force, then why we are not able to feel it? Because the mass of you is not enough, it's so less, and the mass of the object is also very less, and the distance between you and the object is it's also less, but the value of g is very less. You know, it has the value 6.6 10 to the power minus 11, which is a very small quantity. So we are not able to feel the force which is acting between the you and the other objects. Now, do one numerical on this, which is based on the universal law of gravitation. The numerical is, two bodies having the mass of 40 kg, the mass of the one object is 40 kg and the other is 80 kg, though we are representing it by m1 and m2, are at a distance of 0.15 meter. So this is the distance between the object, d is 0.15 meter from each other. The force of gravitation between the bodies are, so F is also here, which is 1.0 into 10 to the power minus 6 Newton. So here in this part, you have to find the value of constant, that is the capital G. Okay. For this question, we will apply the same formula, that is F is equal to G M1 M2 upon T square. Now we are going to put the values here. F is how much? This is 1 into 10 to the power minus 6 is equal to, okay, not minus 6, it is minus 5 here, sorry for that, minus 5 is equal to G into M1 is 40 and M2 is 80 and divided by 0.15 meters square. So the G should be 1 into 10 to the power minus 5 into, we will take it here in multiplication, 0.15 into 0.15 and divided by 40 into 80. So after calculation, you will find that the G is 0.7.0 into 10 to the power minus 11 Newton meter square per kg square. So we know that the values, the G has a constant value, but only for this particular question, you have to find the value of G. Now the next question is, gravitational force between the two bodies is 1 Newton. There are two bodies having the mass, suppose M1, M2, and the force is acting between them is how much? It is 1 Newton. If the distance between them is made twice, now what you are doing? Suppose the initial distance between them is D, and you increase the distance by 2 times. It means now for the second case, this is the one case where the distance is D, and in the second case, we are going to double the distance. The mass of the objects are same. M1 is M1 and M2 is M2. So we are not going to change the mass. What we changed? We changed the D, distance between them. Now in this part, you have to find what will be the force now. You have to find the value of F2. So what is the F1 here? F1 is equal to G M1 M2 upon D square. Okay. So we put the values here. Now, for the second case, what is F2 here? F2 is equal to G M1 M2 upon, the distance is how much? It is 2D square. So, what can we do? We can divide these two equations. For easy calculation, it's an easy method. Divide the both equation. G M1 M2 upon D square divided by G M1 M2 upon 4D square. G cancel out with G M1 M2. And here F1 upon F2 is equal to, we take this value in multiplication by reciprocal it. So it will be 4 upon 1. So we can say F2 is equal to, 4 will come in denominator. It is 1 upon 4 F1. So how much is the force changes? By doubling the distance in between the object, we found that the force between the objects become 1/4 time. 1/4 times of the initial one. Okay, one more simple question. This is calculate the gravitational force. You have to calculate the value of F here between a 20 kg ball. M1 is how much? It is 20 kg, and a 50 kg ball, that is M2, is how much? It is 50 kg. Place at a distance of 8 meter. The distance between the object is 8 meter. So F is equal to, we know that the formula of the F is equal to G M1 M2 upon R square. So I'm going to put the values here. 6.67 10 to the power minus 11 into M1 is how much? 20 into M2 is how much? 50 upon the distance is 8 square. So after calculation, we will find the value will be 0.1.05 into 10 to the power minus 9 Newton. So these are very simple and easy questions based on the Newton law of gravitation, and you have to learn the law, and the numericals are really so easy. You can easily put the values in the formula and can get the answer. Or for any type of question like the assertion reason type of questions, you should be very clear about your chapter. If you are very clear about your chapter, it's really too easy to write the answer of any type of question, like it is assertion reason or is it a paragraph based questions, because in examination you get the assertion reason type of question and even the paragraph based questions. Okay, bye.